Although, as again, somebody might try to go immediately into a full communist society and see how that would work. The main point is that it's not enough, while I have great respect for the Marxist tradition, there's not enough to say, well, there's a crisis, or this is bad. We have to say we have a goal, we have a vision, we have a picture of what a free society would be like. If you read through Kropotkin's books on these subjects, of mutual aid, the conquest of bread, and so forth, you see he doesn't lay out what a society must be like. He's saying, this is what might be like. This is how it could work out. The idea is to raise these things as possibilities, as to show people there's a possibility, there's a better way for human beings to live together. And this isn't just abstract out there, because anarchism organizes today in the same basic values of the way we want to live. Just as we want a society built on free association, on self-governing, radically democratic society, so we want to build a movement today that's built on free association, on self-governing radical mass movements. It's not just a question of individuals, or it's just tactics, and over there is vision. They are together in a dialectical unity. And we have to be showing people today, we show people today, this is how we can rule ourselves. The whole of US and Canadian politics, the entirety of its politics, is built on this key idea of not letting the working class and oppressed people know that they have the power to run society. That's what it's all about. And one big break in that, a general strike in one city, for example, a successful mass movement, the mass struggle in any place in North America, could break through that illusion that people have. And we could say, this is how we want to live. We can live, and you read any count of revolutions in history, how often people say, we just did this, this is how we thought we had to live, we didn't think it could be any better. The well-off, better-off workers and so forth have been bought off, the worse-off workers just demoralized and beaten down, and suddenly they get an experience that life can be different. Collectively, we can make a real free society. And I think that that's what we're talking about when we talk about a vision of a new society in which we're going to educate ourselves and others in a dialogue for building a new world. Thank you.